morning, everybody. So this morning we're going to honor our graduates because they did a pretty amazing thing by graduating either from high school or college. Both those things are pretty awesome. So, can we have some people come up here? I'll read your name. Joel Mott, Connor Mott, Sarah F. Bub, Kristen Lundy.
Freaking.
I was
like,
really was freaked out.
Because,
the graduation announcement,
and
I was like, oh,
nice. James Hill, Dr. Christensen.
Woo!
And,
I know him.
And Keisha.
I know him.
Woo! Woo! Yeah! So we usually buy some stuff every year to represent a few things, and some of them are practical and some of them are just completely not practical. But this year we decided to do a couple things. We were praying about it. And the laundry basket is kind of a twofold thing. One of them is because when Hannah Kubitschek graduated from high school, we didn't do laundry baskets and she berated us afterwards. It was like, hey man, I wanted the laundry basket. We were like, I'm sorry. So this year we're like, oh, she's graduating from college. We're gonna get a laundry basket. So there you go, Hannah. You got it. Fine. Yeah, no problem. Secondly, though, is this. These things all kind of represent three different things: physical, mental, and spiritual. And the laundry basket is physical just because nobody wants to hear about Jesus if you stink. So do your laundry. Please do your laundry. It's important. Whether you're going to college or you're going into the workforce or you're taking a gap year, whatever it is, if you don't already do your laundry, start doing it, because time's over for mom to be doing laundry, you know what I mean?
Preach.
If you do already do your laundry, good, now you have a new laundry basket, and it's a little bit bigger, so I wanted to get the bigger one because I like to get this as full as I can before I have to do laundry, you know what I mean? I don't like the little basket where you're like, oh, two sets of clothes, I guess I'll do a small load. No. Let's bound that up and do it all at once, you know what I mean? The second thing we have in here is, there's a beach towel. Everybody gets a beach towel. And that's for mental health. Yeah, you can pull it out if you want. So we got a beach towel to remind you guys, you're about to either A, go to work for your career that you've been working really hard for, or you're about to go to college that you really don't know what to expect, or you're taking a little bit of time and then you're gonna go straight into ministry. All of those things are very demanding things. And if you don't remember to have fun, take a minute, go to the beach or lake or water source, I don't know, whatever. But take a minute with family and friends and just have some fun. Life without fun is pretty boring if not fun. That's really deep. I'll let that sink in. Yeah, that's okay. That might take a few days. But you want to remember to have fun and make sure that you just give yourself a break. There is some candy in these things. There's some M&Ms and some Swedish fish. I think some Sour Patch Kids or something. Those have no bearing on anything other than it's summertime, binge watch some stuff. Get on Netflix. Even if you're about to go to work, take a weekend, chill. You know what I mean? Just sit in front of a TV and snack, gain 5 pounds, and watch a really cool show. And then the last thing we got you guys, and we kind of handpicked these out, we got you guys these little scented candles. And I know the gentlemen are like, yes! I love me some scented candles. This is the spiritual part of this, and I want you guys to know, we're giving you these candles, but this really means, let it shine, right? Remember that you're the light of the world. Remember that you literally are the light that Christ put in the world. And when you guys have these and you light them, I want you to remember that don't cover your light up. What is it? Don't put it in a bushel basket? Why would you do that anyway? But yeah, hide it under a bushel basket. Wouldn't that light it on fire? Anyway. It's a bigger light, I guess, if you did that. That's fair. But we want you guys to remember that you are God's light. And then when you leave here, or if you don't leave here, but when you go out to start doing adulting stuff, it doesn't change. You're still the light of the world. You're still the light that God wants you to be to other people. So when you light these, and some of them, they actually all smell really good, so hopefully your rooms are just like, oh. But just remember that you're God's, and you're supposed to be out being the light. So don't forget to be the light of the world to other people and the places that you go. I hope you guys use all these things. And if you don't like the color or the stuff in there, fight amongst yourselves later. You guys can figure it out. So would you guys join me in praying for these guys as they embark on the next chapter of their life? And we want to lift them up in prayer to God and make sure that they have a straight path ahead of them. So Father, we just pray for this group. I love these people, God, and I know you love them so much more than I do, which I don't understand, God, because I love them so much, but you do. And God, we pray as they go, or they stay, or they start work, or whatever is next for them, God, this next chapter of their life, God, that they would remember you. And when things get hard and things get tough, God, that they would know, they've been taught, God, you've told them how to take shelter in him, in you, God, how to take shelter in the things of you, how to be able to hide under your wing, Lord, and just get filled up again. And God, I pray as they go that you would make each of their paths straight in front of them. That they would know exactly what they're supposed to do, where they're going, what the end goal is, Father, that you would give them literally a roadmap for your plan for them for the next few years, God. And I pray that you give them a remembrance of your word, Father, of the family that they have back here if they're leaving. God, I pray that you give them a support system where they're going, Father, that there would be other Christians, other believers that would come with them and bolster them and help them stand up straight and be the light that you've called them to be, God. We love them so much, Lord, and we just pray that you bless them as they go. And Father, we ask that you would just give them a great and bright future for each of them. We know that they're going to do awesome things, God, so we ask that you just order their steps. We love you, Lord, and we love them so much, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, let's give them a hand. All right, well, while I'm up here, I'm just going to take over. Is that okay? No, I'm just kidding. So I got a couple of things. Camp. If you are planning to go to summer camp this year, Accelerate, we have paperwork, and it's a